school. It is also true that Pike goes to see Twig, that he should attach the fuse.
Don't redundant.
No, it is not true that Pike goes to see Twig, that he should get ignited the aforesaid fuse.
Why not?
Why not? Because it is said by Harry Race, the Prendang is Romest.
What?
The Prendang is Romest.
Oh, sure, like I always say.
Glad, man. It is grievous to be caught. Harry Race, pardon that.
I wouldn't want to be definitely missing yesterday.
But is it true that you have seen to it that you should borrow the lifeboat?
Yeah, and two water wings. All it is we must do now is light the fuse and proceed away.
A 100 yard north, we should proceed away. That we should await the Tikanda. She'll pick me up, because I am the boss's most valuable future nephew-in-law. And we'll take over the wretched business so he can retire. And marry Heather.
Heather? Miss McCloud? But she hates you.
That is good. For as is said by Sir Walter Raleigh, hatreds are the cinders of affection.
But she hates me too!
I do not think that it is true that she should hate you so much as she should hate me. But there is yet a further point.
Yeah?
The further point is, who should return the lifeboat?
What lifeboat?
The lifeboat that you borrowed for our purposes.
You should return it?
If that would not be right for your conscience, Chuckles, you should do the further point, because it is true that you borrowed it.
By that time, Plato, the lazy Susan will be blown up into many little bits. What if I can't find a bit big enough to tie it to?
The horse should go falling down slowly. If you make enough haste, you should certainly maybe make it.
Without getting definitely misrejected?
It is certain, maybe. Observe, there, the Tikanda. It follows just like the boss has said. In 3 hours, I should ignite the fuse, marry the girl who awaits me, and then happily ever after.
Yeah, boys!
How are we going to get to the dunners below? You go out there. Him? Him? Oh, and him too. I'll see you.
I should wait until they're not looking. If they're not looking, they shouldn't see me.
See where, boy? 300 yards off Fort Bean.
What a mind you have, Plagers. I could have never thought of that.
All right, eh? But now we should keep low.
Yeah.
What the call?
The colors!
United States merchant!
Off 2 degrees.
Sir, 2 degrees.
Can you make out a name, Mr. Lavick?
What's her name?
Tikanda! She's the Tikanda!
Bears from the cloud line. Don't know what I don't know, but what it has to do with young Heather.
So get us right away!
No, I don't like that. Bring her up again.
Aye, aye, sir.
Orville!
Yes, sir!
Be searching out Mr. Baldwin Johnson. Tell him I'll be seeing him up to my quarters.
But he's thrown in for the night, Captain. Them's all turned in.
I'll be waking the ladies. Quick, boy.
You mean the aunt? She ain't been taken too good as of late. Don't you think we're finally to leave her be?
It's Roy.
Yes, sir. Aye, aye, sir, Captain.
Strange way she should be sitting there. Ain't changing course. Ain't cutting speed. Figured if she were to come from Miss McCloud, he'd have signaled us by now. Take over, Mr. Brashew.
Aye, aye, sir.
Don't know how you done it, Pickles, but I will find out soon enough.
I don't know what you be talking about, old man.
Oh, you don't know, don't you?
Don't know what?
What don't he know?
Yeah, what don't I know?
So you don't know about the Brahmas missing, five man reading the book disappearing.
Want me to gum?
I wouldn't be so sure on that.
Oh, now wouldn't you?
I would.
Oh, then don't!
Looks guilty to me, he does.
My fat and happy over there.
Yup, he be guilty.
I ain't guilty!
No need to yell.
Yup, no need to yell.
Show me a man with yells, and I'll show you a man with guilty. It be a fact.
Yup, it be a fact.
Ask me! Oh, Dad did it so just so he could blame it on me.
No, sir, I ain't the one.
Well, if you aren't the one, then I certainly will. Who be the one?
Rest us on, it's natural.
If it weren't you, who was it?
don't know. There's strange things going on this Windjammer. Other night I thought I saw myself a ghost. If I didn't see it, I sure did hear it. Was a fine ghost. Went like this. Hip, hop, hop. Hoop, hoop, hoop.
The ghost of Captain Kidd.
Captain Kidd?
We're a kid. He don't need to run.
How come?
This is already one.
Already one what?
Already a blooming spirit. Spirit don't need spirits.
If it ain't Kidd, then it be the blooming zombie.
Zombies? Zombies? It be the zombies, I do say.
It's disgusting that we be talking about zombies this way. No, Dad, didn't be such just...
Yeah.
Show me a man who says, buh, 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 and I'll show you a man who's scared.
Buh, buh, buh.
What are you talking about?
It be a blooming zombie!
Stars. But I can't be selfish. No, I can't.
Uncle Hayden will destroy Captain Renfro. He will destroy them all if I don't return.
We should take Miss McCloud with us.
Stupid, that she no blow up the lazy suit.
Shh! She ain't gonna turn to her own uncle. Or me, who it is true that she hates so much that she loves. There, find her! Put her on the lifeboat!
My uncle sent the steamship for me. I must insist on returning.
It is not time I should ignite the fuse.
Dear Bagby, will we ever meet again?
I will take full responsibility.
For lives of 20 men? No, sir. I know Adrian Beresford. I know what he can do to them to cross him. We ain't got no choice. When the Cunning sends his boat alongside, we gotta send Miss McCloud back with him.
I know Beresford too. Just as well as you do. And if you ask me.
I ain't asking you, Bagby. If you know Beresford as well as I do, you wouldn't have been so smart to him back to the dock when we cast off. We're gonna might more fearful if we know.
Did you know what you were doing when you agreed to ship our sugar, sir?
Yes, I did.
Then you must accept it. The inevitable fact that Hayden and Beresford were trying to destroy you.
Gore, of course I did, but I'll tell you this, youngster. I ain't sending no 20 men to the bottom just so I can help his niece run away.
Do you have any choice?
Of course I do.
Your only choice is to defend yourself. Fight back. Stand your ground. If you allow men for them to kind of deport your ship at will, to remove one of your passengers.
Ain't nobody gonna do that.
Then they will know that they can push you until you quit.
Bilge!
It's not just the times the steamships you're fighting, Captain Elijah Renfro. If it were, you would certainly win. It's every unscrupulous devil whose pride or pocket you nudge. Every Hadrian bear
yes, single
get.
No, sir, nothing yet.
Thank you, Mr. Bradshaw. Well, sir, you'd be right. That don't solve no problems.
You mean, you won't turn Miss McCloud over to him?
I mean, I got no choice but to stand my ground. And they ain't come for Miss McCloud. They probably don't even know she's a boy. No, they come for something else.
You mean?
I don't know. They've been watching us mighty suspicious. Like something more about to happen here.
We can put it in Charleston and report them to the authorities.
No, it wouldn't do no good. They ain't broke no law.
Isn't there anything we can do?
Yes, sir, we can be searching out the entire ship, looking for a stowaway up to no good. Somebody working for Beresford. Bagby, you can be sticking with young Wolf on the ladies.
Yes, sir, I will. Are they below now?
Cloud Moon will be, sir. No, wait. Miss McCloud was... Yeah, she was walking the deck. Yeah. Strange. She don't be around now.
Mr. Ryle, Pickles, on there.
Aye, sir.
Yes, sir.
Hands up. Be searching out the entire ship. Step and start looking for a stowaway. I need to see Miss McCloud standing below.
It's Miss McCloud!
Baby, grab that man!
Windjammer.
That ain't right! He ain't no fool!
Thunder and lava, my smart talk.
Johnson. Just so
she... Avast!
Well, it be the truth, don't it, sir?
Mr. Rye, I'll be seeing you whip for insubordination.
But, Captain, you ain't got no more command.
Mr. Rye, I still got command of this lifeboat. First one of y'all thinks different's got me to deal with.
Apologies, sir.
Ask me. Be a mighty fine thing Mr. Wilder Johnson be doing.
Bag me! Bag me, Wilder Johnson, call out! Pull to, you bubbers. There's a beach over there. Pull to.
Be hanged if I thought Miss McCloud was in on this.
Don't know, Elma. Just don't know. Pull to, you bubbers!
Thank you. is legally dead. Accidents can be efficient on occasion. Once the death becomes the insignificant, such as Boulevard Johnson matter, accidents are means and help one perfect the ideal scheme. I now own the entire company.
Sorry, Thurman. Cloud refused to eat, and I cannot force her.
You are not to mention her name, Mr. Thurman. I believe you know that. Well, we can't ever starve, can we? This bothers to not have placed us around. He was so good at such things.
Yes, I hated to do it, Tom.
He knew too much. Couldn't trust us.
You can always trust me, sir.
Well, leave her food in her garret. She will eat. She doesn't have that much will, you know. Now that she is legally dead, we must decide what to do with her. That'll be all.
Are you certain you can make it, Arnold?
Of course I can. Up the drain pipe to the eaves. Round the garret window. Easy.
I will keep him occupied. Giving him back our sugar business was a gesture which should keep him off guard. He is incapable of suspecting human loyalty when it opposes financial gain.
Miss McClass has got to be up there.
She's got to be up there. The captain of the Anaconda claims he picked up no survivors. He had three sailors laid off last month, believed in a lifeboat, carrying two men and a girl, was picked up within 100 yards of the wreckers. My guess is that Barrister is holding her captive until she's declared legally dead. Her holdings in the company would revert to her. At least, there's hope.
Can you give me a lift to the cell?
Go as fast as you can, Arnold.
Mr. Thurman!
You called, sir?
We must do it, my niece. It would be bad form to have her turn up now.
I know.
Handled in the usual way. Captain Hart of the Kindle will know what to do.
Now, sir?
Yes, now. There's the door.
You can always trust me, sir.
Johnson!
You guessed it, old bean.
Mr. Bolivar Johnson, how pleasant to see you, sir.
Pleasant day.
We always enjoy seeing our best customers. The car.
Nice of you.
That'll be all, Mr. Thurman. Take a seat, good man. Out the back.
Thank you.
We are most grateful to have your account again. It was devastating to me personally to be at odds with the son of my lifelong friend.
And financially.
That matters too, of course.
It certainly does. But at least you.
But the personal loss was paramount.
Here, here, let's not fool each other.
Just like your father. No one puts anything by you, do they?
Is that what you were doing? Well, I suppose we must ship by steam. There isn't a windjammer in these waters which can cater to our demands. After Redfern's down, Easter went down.
Please, I beg you not to mention that. My niece, you know. It was gross irresponsibility on Redfern's part. Everyone agrees. A man like that should be put in jail.
That was quite a practical joke the Ship Association played on him.
We felt it was our duty to teach him a lesson. That man's pride is his downfall. I imagine you've heard the story. It's really quite funny.
All I know is that he sailed on the bark across the North Atlantic on a bet.
A 16-foot sloop. Single-handed.
At his age, he doesn't stand a chance.
That's just it. Everyone was angry about Heather. The Shippers Association agreed to buy the finest out eastern Maine. We can sail across the North Atlantic and return in a bark of their choosing. At first, he refused. We made him the laughing stock of Mackay's. We told him he was too old. We told him he was washed up. Then he got mad, and he accepted. And you should have seen the bark we gave him. It was the most rotten piece of mildew that ever graced a cow pasture.
Now I know you were capable of doing.
It's only a joke. Been a thorn in our side for years.
It's Heather! It's Heather!
You're hearing things, good man. Hearing things.
Coming out the window. Stop her!
We can't have this, can we?
No, don't
you. Can't spoil things. We can't have this, can we? Can't spoil things now, can we? Can't spoil things.
Hey.
Tell your secret.
Have you no compassion?